A very good morning to all my dear lovely students. I hope you all are fit and fine at your home. So my dear students, I welcome you to yet another class of lesson number 9, My Kite. So how many of you know to fly a kite? Have you ever touched a kite in your hand? Yes, have you ever tried to fly a kite? I hope you all have done that, right? So my dear students, it's a very beautiful poem that we are going to read today about the kite. So the name of the poem is My Kite. But before that, do you remember what we have done in our previous class? In our previous class, we have learned about the rhyming word. So can you tell me which poem we have learned? We have learned about rain poem. Yes. So what was the poem? Rain, rain, go away, come again another day. Little Johnny wants to play. Rain, rain, go away. Am I right? So my dear students, from that poem, we have also sought out the rhyming words. And I'm really happy that many of you have tried to answer all the questions. Yes, you all have tried to pair out the rhyming words, right? Okay, so my dear students, in our today's class, as we have already learned about the rhyming words, yes, sorry. So today, we are going to read the poem from lesson number 9. Okay, so in our today's class, we will be covering the reading portion. So what is the objective that we are going to get from today's class? We are going to achieve. We are going to read aloud with proper pronunciation and modulation. Okay, so I know you all know to read very nicely. Yes, but reading silently will do nothing. Whenever you have to read any poem, you need to read aloud so that when you read it, you can just get the interest, you can just get the idea of what you are reading. So now, what do you mean by modulation? What ma'am is talking about modulation, right? So modulation is that you need to know where to stop. Yes, your body gesture, your voice, where you need to just raise your voice, you need to just make it higher or make it lower. Yes, got it? Okay, so my dear students, please come to page number 3 of your textbook. Yes, and I think you all remember what is the rule of reading the poem or any chapter. What you need to do, you need to point your finger in where? Each lines where ma'am will read, right? Okay, so my dear students, without doing further delay, let's start our reading portion. Okay, so the name of the poem, My Kite. Flip flap, rises my kite up and up in the sky that is so blue and bright. Flip flap goes my kite, sometimes to my left and sometimes to my right. Flip flap flies my kite high and high above. It fills me with delight. Yes, got it? Okay, let's do one more time. Okay. Flip flap rises my kite up and up in the sky that is so blue and bright. Flip flap goes my kite sometimes to my left and sometimes to my right. Flip flap flies my kite high and high above. It fills me with delight. Yes, so my dear students, can you see there are many new words in the poem? Am I right? So which is the first new word that we get here? The first new word is rises. R-I-S-E-S. Rises. Yes, the second is bright. B-R-I-G-H-T. Bright. The third one is left. L-E-F-T. Left. And the fourth one is right. R-I-G-H-T. Right. The fifth one is above. A-B-O-V-E. Above. Right. And the last word is delight. D-E-L-I-G-H-T. Delight. So how can you sew rises? R-I-S-E-S, rises. Yes, you can see the sun rises. Yes or no? So how can you show it? Rises. The kite flies very up. It rises high up in the sky. Right? So bright. How can you show bright? Bright. Yes, it's very bright. The sun shines very bright. So left, how can you show left? You can just show your left hand. Yes, just pointing the left side. Am I right? So what is the opposite of left? It's right. Showing your right hand. Yes, showing the direction of right side. Yes, now above. What? How can you show above? Over your head. Yes, above. So the last word is delight. It's very related to something. If I have to say, when I get something, gift, when I get, I'm very happy. Yes, so what do you mean by delight? Delight means happy. So in the poem, the child is very happy, very delighted because he was just flying the kite. Got it? Okay, so my dear students, we always need to read the poem with very, what? Proper modulation and also proper, yes, pronunciation, right? Okay, so my dear students, who is going to answer me now? What is the main thing that you need to keep in your mind while reading a poem? Okay, so who is going to answer me that? I hope every one of you have understood what are the main points that you need to keep in your mind while reading a poem. So you will write down that and you will show that to me. Okay, so my dear students, we have done the reading of the beautiful poem My Kite. In our next class, we will be doing the explanation. I'll explain the poem and also we'll do many other activities related to the poem. Okay, so for today, what you have to do, you have to read the poem thoroughly. Okay, very nicely, each thing you have to read it. And I hope you have read it yesterday, as I have given one assignment, and that was of that you have to find out the rhyming words from the poem. So which are the rhyming words that we got here? Is kite, bright, right, delight, right? Okay, so my dear students, please read the poem, and also you need to keep practicing reading many books. Okay, and along with that, you need to also practice handwriting. Got it? Okay, so my dear students, that's all for today. We will be meeting up again in our next class. So my dear students, that's all. Thank you and have a nice day.